How does the situation seem here in the Aklan area?
Aklan actually been relatively good, for that's my opinion and for my assessment. The situation has been returning normal. The shops are mostly open. The markets are working most of the time. There's much less stuff on the market than usually, and there's still problems with the phone lines, the communications, and the televisions and stuff like that. But otherwise, it seems to be that the things are getting back to the normal. What's the problematic here is actually that a lot of the people have lost their homes, and like in this Yolanda case or this Haiyan typhoon case, like in most of the disaster cases, the people who lost their homes are already the people who are most vulnerable in the communities. A lot of the people have built up their houses with only bamboo and other very light materials. A lot of these houses are washed away, and now they have to rely on the shelter, rebuild their small houses, and get back to the normal life. And this will take a long time. Other problem is, of course, food, because once you lose your home, you lose your economy at the same time, and you need to get somewhere to eat. If you can't respond to food and the shelter and the water also, then it leads to the health problems in the long run, or actually very in very short term. And that will lead to the major problems in this situation. So we need to be able to respond to the food situation and also to the shelter situation. Luckily, the water situation has been actually very good in Aklan. In Aklan, during the previous disasters, like the Frank typhoon or the Frank hurricane, they rebuilded their water sources to withstand the new typhoons. And this preparedness work really shows up at the moment, because the water haven't been a problem, like it's been a problem in Cebu and some other areas. A lot of the areas, like in Aklan, we PNSs have been supporting some of the community-based disaster response work. Like the Finnish Red Cross has been working here in the Mobo, where we're actually standing at the moment, supporting a CBDRR approach, which has been done around the Philippines with the same method. So we train the volunteer people here, we form up the disaster preparedness groups, we work together with the community, and we prepare for the typical disasters, which every year, these are in this Mobo scenario, for example, there are always floods. Every year there's floods, every year there's some kind of a typhoons. Luckily, the scale of the Haiyan or the Yolanda has been exceptionally high. I mean, you usually end up in a situation like this, but it shows that it pays up to prepare, because there's been very little loss of life, there's been very little injured, actually, but there's a lot of infrastructure destruction, which can be unfortunately avoided only with the preparedness work. But what can be done is then to respond to the needs of the people once they start their normal life.